Welcome to this video from In 28 Minutes. Thanks for helping us provide awesome learning experiences to more than 300,000 learners across multiple platforms, Udemy, Safari, and Pact. Let's welcome our lead instructor, Rangarao Karanam. In this video, we will be talking about something called eventual consistency. Whenever we talk about microservices architecture, we would want to have eventual consistency. What is that? Let's focus on that in this specific video. Now, whenever we go for microservices architecture, you know that we would have a number of smaller microservices instead of larger single deployable application. So we would have a number of microservices, and one of the things that we would use to market the microservices architecture is to say, I can have microservice 1 in Spring Boot, microservice 2 in Node.js, microservice 3, let's say in Python, and different architectures for microservice 4 and microservice 5. The thing is, that's not really a good situation to be in, because if you have different architectures for each of these microservices, what would happen is it becomes difficult to maintain them. The kind of themes you would need to maintain microservice 2 is different from microservice 4. And that's a big headache that you would not really want to get into. Now, it's very, very important that you have the capability to innovate, right? So if there is a new framework out there which you think is good, you'd really want to try it. So in that sense, a microservice 5 might be using a new framework which is a little different from microservice 1. But that should not mean that the microservice 5 is completely different from microservice 1. One of the ways you can do that is by having a standard reference architecture. So whenever you have a microservices architecture being used, then you should have a reference architecture which says this is the standard way of doing things. Whenever there is something new comes in, you would evaluate it and you would check whether it suits our specific needs, whether it's something you would want to give it a try. And then you would find the right place where you would want to implement it, specific microservice, implement it, try it out. And if it's good, then you'd kind of bring it into the microservices reference standard. And that's how you'd ensure that microservices are eventually consistent. There might be a small amount of variation in all times because you'd want to always keep innovating. You'd want to try new frameworks, new languages, new protocols, or new ways of communicating. So you'd always want to keep trying out new stuff. But one of the most important things that you need to make sure is that you are clear about what are the new things that are being tried out. You have a little bit of governance around it. And at all times, you are trying to have as much consistency as possible. It's a difficult balance to find because you'd want these microservices to be consistent, but you'd also want to keep innovating. And that's where the eventual consistency comes into picture. So you try new things and you would bring everything to be consistent. In 28 Minutes is providing awesome learning experiences to 300,000 learners across platforms like Udemy, Safari Online, and Pact. We have clocked million hours of learning in the last few months. Keep learning in 28 Minutes.